Crusader Football on Country 93.1 Radio. Joining me right now is the head coach of the Crusaders with a 26-2 career record as a head coach, two-time defending state champion. It's Steve Zerwan. And, Coach, another season at the helm for you. This one probably a little bit different. You lost quite a bit of players from last year's state championship team, but at the same time, you got a lot of guys that saw some action.
Yeah, we had a tremendous group of seniors off the guys that really started for us for 3 years in 2012, 13, 14. Now those guys have moved on, but a new crop coming in. I believe we have seven seniors this year, led by Jake Holt and Jake Holt and Nate Jones, both guys who are four-year starters for us. Jacob Schulte, who's going to be a three-year starter. Christian Martinez, who's going to start at quarterback for us as a senior, as well as Savion Thompson, who's going to play both ways as both a tight end and a linebacker. And then, of course, got a couple guys like Chase Simpson and Brody Keefe, guys that are just excellent athletes that had some misfortune of injuries last year that will be back on the field for us this year.
You talked to one name in there, Christian Martinez. It's his first year as a quarterback. He did get a couple big games in last year for you guys. But he's a little bit different quarterback than Nicholas Holt.
He's a little bit different. Christian got some valuable experience when Nick got injured last year. Christian ended up having two starts for us in the Country Day game and in the Ravenna game, games that we had, some really good offensive production in. And Christian played the whole semifinal game aside from about three, four plays when Nick re-injured his ankle. So he's a guy that's got some big game experience. He's been up playing varsity basketball since he was 13 years old. So again, he's a guy that's used to playing, at this kind of, competition, this level. Yeah, is he different? Yeah, he's different. He throws well, and he's probably the best, actually passer we've had here since I would say Blake Evans back about 15 years ago. And I think he's really coming around. He's grown into his body. He's about 6'2 now, and I think people would be surprised at the way he runs the ball this year as well.
All right, you talked about he's a good passer, and one of his targets this year is going to be Nate Jones, who's been starting for three straight years at center for you guys.
Yeah, Nate's always probably been a natural tight end, but again, you're just trying to get your five best linemen on the field when you go tackle to tackle, and Nate's been that for years. We've developed some younger kids behind him, and Bobby Judice, we feel real comfortable with him playing center this year, and it's just kind of a way for us to, we feel, solidify the right side of our line by moving Nate to tight end. We're going to line up Jake Holt next to Brock Johnson, and then next to Nate Jones at end. So we feel that's three really quality guys on the right side of that line.
And you talk about the line's always a key for the Crusaders. You got to establish on both offense and defense. And with Jacob leading the way, with all the experience he's had as a starter as well, that's a real nice cushion for you.
Yeah, it is. Just the fact that we do have, again, Nate and Jacob Holt that you mentioned. Jacob Holt really is as good as a player, I feel, in the area. And I think he's been as good as a player that's been in the area the last couple of years. It's kind of hard for him to get kind of maybe the notoriety that some others did just because he was always younger. Well, now it's his time as a senior, and again, he brings some great leadership and just a great physicality to our team. So I think Jake's looking exceptionally forward to his senior year, and again, he's going to be asked to fill that leadership role of some of the seniors that left.
Well, 2 years ago, you graduated Alex Lewandowski, one of the really good running backs. All Tommy Scott did last year was get named Division 7-8 Player of the Year for his effort. This year, you have three juniors in the backfield.
Yeah, three juniors, and we really feel that each one is just as capable as the other. Let Tommy Scott, who's the brother of Tommy Scott, is going to play the right half for us. Logan Helton, who started at fullback last year, is a year older and going to be the fullback as well. And then Walker Christofferson, a kid that transferred into our school last January, is going to be the left half. And all three kids are fast kids. And we're teaching them to be more and more physical each day. So we feel when we're in our full house package, we can take advantage of each of them. There's not just one back to key on. And then when we start going to more of our multiple formation looks, I think you got to be worried about where each of those guys are on the field.
Talk a little bit about your team defensively. Again, the same story. Lost a lot of guys, but still have a lot of guys that, even though they didn't start games, played in a lot of games last year.
Yeah, that's correct. I just think guys that come to mind is Brock Johnson is going to be playing both ways for us, and he saw a lot of time as the season went on playing some defensive tackle. And Savion Thompson, he ended up being our starting tight end. But I think he ended up playing most of like weeks 1 through 4 when Jake Kimbrough was hurt for a little while at that outside linebacker position. Miles Navani, he ended up playing a lot last year at linebacker in some of those games that got a little bit out of hand. And LaTommy Scott's going to play corner. He you know, he played some corner for us last year. So like you said, I think we have 9 new starters on defense. But again, guys that have played quite a bit at varsity, but maybe weren't full-time starters.
And then the special teams aspect of things, obviously Nicholas Holt was your punter, but bigger loss, Griffin Seymour, your PAT kicker and your field goal kicker. He's in the state record books for the efforts he put in the last couple of years. How are you going to replace him?
I don't know if you ever replaced Griffin, but you're definitely, that's one department you're looking for consistency. If it's kickoff and it's, the extra point field goal unit, you're just looking to get a consistent snap and a consistent hold and a consistent kick out of those things. We're going to go with Jose Zambrano, who is new to the football program, but he's been at the school here. He's played soccer. He's going to be a sophomore. And he's got a real nice leg and just kind of teaching him that, you know, soccer is a little bit different than football as far as kicking it. But he's got a real powerful leg, and he should be able to handle the extra point and the kickoff duties for us, along with Caleb Muscovin, who also is he's a more than capable kicker, could also be there kicking. And then Trenton Bordeaux, who's also new to our program, transferred in. Him and Christian Martinez are still kind of neck and neck on who's going to do the punting duties. And Andrew Schulte will be that critical snapper on both the short snap and the long snap. So, yeah, definitely some new people to replace on special teams as well. But, again, that's high school football. You know, you have guys and new guys shuffle in.
Well, and something else new this year, hard to believe, for the first time in the history of this program, you're taking on Oak Ridge. And it's another rich tradition school, especially football wise, but opening with them week one, it's not going to get easy, or it's not easy off the bat for you guys with them right on the schedule.
No, it's not. I just think it's a great game for both communities, the Catholic community, the Oak Ridge community, both two people and that really, the people that follow those programs, I think really love football, and they love a certain brand of kind of hard-nosed football, and I think that's exactly the kind of game you're going to see out there. You know, I get that question a lot as far as, you know, first game, are you getting more prepared? I mean, if you're playing anybody, you're going to get as prepared as you can, and you're going to kind of worry about the same type of things. But the fact it's a big game right off the bat with a big atmosphere, I think is great for our kids, and it's going to test us right away. You know, win or lose, the final goal is to win that, you know, fifth or sixth game and qualify for the playoffs and just assure that you're going to be playing in week 10 in the state tournament. So, you know, again, it's going to be a great game, great atmosphere, and you know, again, win or lose, it's going to be something that we can definitely hopefully build on.
And final question for you, taking a look at the Lakes 8 Conference again, obviously you guys are marked men this year, not that you weren't last year, even though it was your first year in the league, you dominated on your way to a conference championship. Everybody's looking at you again this year, and they might be coming at you even a little bit harder.
Yeah, that's the nature of playing in league competition, and when you're the team that won the conference, I think definitely teams want to be gunning for you and win that championship and take it away from you. I think it's going to be just an excellent conference this year as well. I think Fruitport is in my mind probably the team that's going to be the most improved. I just think what they have returning coming back and just the big physical type guys they have up front, I think they're going to pose a challenge by the fact that we're going there this year. You know, of course, you've always got, you know, I Spring Lake is always in the mix in that conference, and Orchard View, I think, is going to be a little bit improved. So, again, it should be a very competitive league this year, and just, you know, again, looking forward to getting some quality games, and hopefully it adds up enough where the Crusaders are playing that final week in October.
All right, riding a 26-game win streak, that is Coach Steve Zerwan of the Muskegon Catholic Central Crusaders. Coach, thanks for your time. Best of luck this season.
All right, thanks, Matt. Look forward to talking to you soon.
We'll be back after this here on DSC TV.
People have put together photo collages for special occasions. They go through the photo album and old shoe boxes and pull out their favorite photos and put them on poster boards. The boards are a great way of sharing stories, but it can be a pretty tedious job. Well, we here at Clocks, we want to make that job easier for you. So just bring us all the photos and we'll scan them into the computer, and then we'll print out the collages on our large format printer. That way, all the photos will be in digital format so you can share them with your friends and relatives.
At Bowman's Body Shop, we're proud to say you're driving home our reputation. Our team of highly skilled professionals uses the latest high-tech equipment to diagnose the extent of the damage to your vehicle. Bowman's Body Shop, 2846 Getty Street in Muskegon.
The Glenside and Northside pubs, from sandwiches, burgers, and Mexican food to starters, salads, soups, and desserts, not to mention their specialty pizzas like Hawaiian, vegetarian, chicken Alfredo, and, of course, their grand finale. It's the Glenside and Northside pubs.
Beginning as a lumber company in 1911, Frederick's Construction has been servicing the Muskegon area since 1969. Family-owned and operated, they specialize in roofing, siding, windows, insulation, additions, doors, decks, and more. Located at 1940 Commerce Street in beautiful downtown Muskegon, their phone number is 231-722-3937. When you want quality workmanship, you want Frederick's Construction.
Welcome back to the Muskegon Catholic Football Season Preview. My name is Matt Chapkus right now, joined by one of the leaders of this Crusader squad in his fourth year starting on varsity. It's Jacob Holt. Jacob, this year a little bit different look to the team. Obviously, you got rid of a lot of seniors, but you guys got a good core back again this year.
Yeah, we lost a lot of seniors in that class, but we have a lot returning back, and we've gotten a lot of work in this summer and even last year during the year because of the games we've been able to get people in.
All right, now talk a little bit about the season outlook. We'll start with week one with Oak Ridge. New foe for you guys, but someone that you guys hear about every year. I mean, Oak Ridge has always had a very good football team. It's about time these two teams got together and settled it on the field, isn't it?
Yeah, we always hear about Oak Ridge, how they always have a good year and they make good playoff run. And I think it'll be a great game having both of our storied programs play against each other in week one.
All right, talk. We'll go with the Lakes 8 season after that. Obviously, you guys did pretty well in the league last year, going on an undefeated record, but probably a little bit different look. Everybody's going to have a target on your back this year.
Yeah, we'll definitely have to be giving our best against everybody. You never know what other teams will come out with, and we just got to be prepared for every game coming in that.
All right, and then weeks 8 and 9, of course, we've got Detroit Country Day, a little road trip for you guys, a Saturday afternoon game, and then Ravana for week 9, but really the number that matters most to you guys is probably 6 again this year, isn't it? Trying to get to that 6 wins so you can guarantee week 10.
Yeah, our goal has been for the past 2 years to get to week 10. We're not thinking about any of the future. We just want to get to week 10 and see what happens from there.
All right. And tell me a little bit about what the play is going to be like on the lines this year. We'll start with the offensive line. You're going to be back at your guard position?
Yes, I'll be a guard on offense and then a defensive end on defense.
Okay. And do you set personal goals when you go into a season like this, or is it just you're more worried about getting possibly to that 14th week of the season?
Yeah, I'm more worried about team goals. I don't really set forward personal goals. I just like to look at the team and try to get to week 10.
All right, that is Jacob Holt from the Muskegon Catholic Central Crusaders. Jacob, thank you for your time. Best of luck this year.
Thank you.
Joined by Christian Martinez. Christian, you're taking over a team that's won 26 straight games. You were the quarterback last year for a couple of those games. But this year, it's your gig to handle. Tell me your emotions heading into this season.
Just excited. We've been working for so long, and we've been looking forward to this week for such a long time. I'm just excited, and I'm prepared, but it's just a lot of excitement with it.
Okay, tell me a little bit about what the offense is going to look like with you back there. Is it going to be that much different from what we saw last year with Nick?
I mean, it shouldn't be that much different. We still run same things. We've installed some new things, but the offense won't be that much different.
Okay, one of your new targets this year was the guy that was your center last year, Nate Jones. Jones, you got any hands on him?
Yeah, he does. He's got a nice pair of hands on him. He's got a nice body, so he's a big target. He's easy to find, and I like throwing to him.
Okay, so you hoping to air it out a little bit more this season, or are you content if we just stick to the ground game?
Yeah, I mean, I would love to air it out more, but it's up to Zerwan, and whatever works for the team and whatever helps the team the best is what I want. So,
all right, and we talked to Jacob Holt. He already mentioned team goals to get to week 10 this year once again, and it seems to be a pretty steady theme throughout everybody. I would assume it's the same with you as well.
Yeah, we just want to take it week by week, give our best each week, and get to week 10. And if we prepare week for week as hard as we can, we'll get there.
Now, I do have to talk about one last thing. You got a new number this year. Were you hoping a little of that number five magic rubs off on you for this year?
Yeah, I am. I wanted to switch it up, and I hope it rubs off because there was a lot of success with this number last year.
Absolutely. That was Tommy Scott, the Division 7-8 Player of the Year, wearing that number last year. We're excited to see Christian under center and leading this Crusader offense this year. Christian Martinez, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
We'll be back after this here on DSE TV.
Locally owned and operated, J. Stevens Construction has been serving the West Michigan area since 1985. Fully licensed, bonded, and insured, they train certified technicians to install single-ply membrane roofing for residential, commercial, and industrial buildings.
Serving the Fruitport area for over 40 years, Grover Pharmacy offers a full line of vitamins, supplements, and homeopathic medicines, as well as a variety of glucometers, blood pressure kits, baby care items, bandages, and wound care products. They carry office and school supplies, Russell Stover candies, promotional and seasonal items, and Hallmark cards and gifts. Grover Pharmacy, they take time to care about you.
Welcome back to the high school football preview of Muskegon Catholic Central here on DSE TV. My name is Matt Chapkus, right now joined by Savion Thompson of the Muskegon Catholic Central Crusaders. And Savion, you're a player that's grown up in this program for quite a while. How exciting is it to finally be a senior in leading this squad?
It's really exciting. You know, coming in a freshman year, like, you think that this day will never come. You know, now it's here, and I'm being asked to step up and be a leader for the team.
Now talk about, we'll start with defense with you, from your linebacker position. You led a team that didn't even allow 100 points in 14 games last year. It was an outstanding defense. Obviously, a lot of those guys have left, but you're still out there. Talk about some of your defensive goals for this season.
Well, we don't want to let the other team score. That's pretty much the big thing. Know all of our assignments. It's pretty much a big part of defense.
Okay, and Coach Zerwan has said even though you guys lost some linemen from last year, you got a nice big line in front of you. How does that change the outlook of the game when you got guys up front freeing up space for you?
It really helps out a lot. You know, having a big line, then having very athletic backs, you know, that'll get the job done.
And tell me a little bit about offense. You're back to the in position again this year. You got a new quarterback, Christian Martinez, and three new running backs running behind you this year. So you know what you're going to be doing, but it's probably a little bit of a learning curve with a different quarterback and different running backs.
Logan Helton and Tommy Scott, you know, they pretty much know what they're doing. Christian isn't really new. Walker is new in the system, but, you know, it wasn't like a big super adjustment. You know, they've all came along pretty fine.
All right, and talk about the Lakes 8 Conference again this year. You guys ran the table last season. Teams are going to be looking for you this year.
Yeah, we have to come in every game with the same mindset, you know, because anyone can be beat. We have to play our best game because we know it's a bunch of teams coming for us.
All right, that is Savion Thompson of the Muskegon Catholic Central Crusaders. Savion, thanks for your time. Good luck this year.
Thanks for having me.
My name is Matt Chapkus, joined by senior Brody Kieft. And Brody, first of all, it's just good to see you back in a uniform again this year.
Very good to be back. I'm excited.
Tell me a little bit about the trials and tribulations you went through last year and the hoops that you had to jump through to get back in a uniform this year.
Well, during the fourth game, I got diagnosed with a concussion. And I was out for about a week. And then I got another one, or a reoccurring one. And they told me that I would most likely never play football again. And then the week after the state championship game, they ended up clearing me and telling me that I'd be able to play. So it was a rough year all around.
Well, the good news is this year you get to get back on the field doing what you do best. Tell me a little bit about where – let's start offensively. I know you were in the backfield two seasons ago. We saw quite a bit of you, actually. Are you hoping to get the ball on a little bit and run with it again this year?
I mean, I'm hoping to, but I'm expecting not to very often. I'm a much more defensive player now, much more.
Okay, and tell me a little bit about where are you going to line up this year defensively?
I have been an outside linebacker quite a bit, and I've been getting a lot better. I've been I had a lot of problems with thinking last year, so I should be there. That's where I'm expecting to be.
Okay, and talk again a little bit about team goals for this season. Obviously, getting to the postseason is the most important.
All I'm worried about is week 10. That's all I'm looking forward to. I want to get 6 wins, and then whatever happens after that, we'll see. But I want week 10 real bad.
All right, that's senior Brody Keefe. Brody, good to see you back. Best of luck this season.
Thank you.
We'll be back after this.
ASAP Auto Sales, located at 2486 South Getty Street in Muskegon, offers a wide selection of reasonably priced used vehicles from cars and trucks to vans, SUVs, and four-wheel drives. With new selections coming in every day, ASAP's lot is always full, which means whenever you drop in, there's about 100 vehicles to choose from. With a wide selection of vehicles, both domestic and import, they have it all. ASAP Auto Sales, 231-830-9000.
Welcome back to the preview of high school football, Muskegon Catholic Central, right here on DSC TV. My name is Matt Chapkis, and right now I am joined by Jake Schulte. And Jake, one of the keys to the Crusader team every year is being able to move the ball on the ground, and you're one of the guys doing the dirty work in the trenches. Tell us a little bit about what it's going to be like this year with 3 new running backs behind you.
Well, we're looking forward to it. All 3 running backs are very fast. They follow their blockers, and we have a good line, so I think it's going to be interesting to see how they do.
Okay, now where are you fitting in on the line this year?
Left guard again. So.
Okay, and what's the perks of being the left guard on this Crusader team?
You get to pull a lot. We're a very, very good team at pulling. It's always good to go around the end and get that good hit. I'll be protecting Christian's blind side this year, so that's always some good trust between me and the quarterback. And all in all, it's just a good spot.
All right, and flip the ball over defensively. Again, your line controlled a lot of things last year. Where are you going to be contributing on the defense for the Crusaders?
I'll be a tackle this year. Again, it's just we got 2 new tackles. It's me and Brock, and it's going to be interesting to see how we do there too.
All right, excited for the season?
Oh, for sure.
Week 1 against Oak Ridge, and then you got league play coming up. Tell us a little bit about being the marked man in the Lakes 8 this year.
Well, we've been marked for the past couple of years. I mean, we're up for the challenge, that's for sure. We like challenges, and we're ready to face anybody that comes at us.
All right, that is Jake Schulte, senior, on this year's Crusader football squad. Jake, thanks for your time. Best of luck.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, right now I'm joined by another senior on this Crusader squad, Chase Simpson. And Chase, a lot of work on the ground last year for you guys. And this year, there's some new faces back there. But again, ground game's going to be critical for this Crusader team.
Yeah, I'm just looking to fill Jaden's shoes as best as I can, because replacing him after not being here last year, it's going to be a challenge.
All right. Tell us a little bit about what will your duties primarily be offensively?
Protecting Christian's backside on the pass game, and just creating a hole for the running backs.
Okay, and those running backs, you got some new guys back there, like we said, but still a lot of speed back there. You got three quick guys that could break at any time.
Yeah, some new talent coming up, and you got Tommy Scott's little brother, so I don't think there will be any problem there filling his shoes.
Talk about defensively. You guys got to do a lot of dirty work down in the trenches again this year. Where's your spot going to be?
I'll be subbing in at tackle between Brock and Schulte. We got like a three-man thing going.
Okay, and again, stopping the runs just as critical as getting the run going offensively. For you guys, spent a lot of time in the weight room in the off season. What dividends is that paying for you when you're trying to control those lines?
Yeah, strength is key because it really helps when you have to move that guy and create the hole, or on defense when you have to plug that hole, you know, so that the running back can't come through.
All right, tell us a little bit about team goals for this season. Obviously, a 26-game winning streak. Like to keep that going, especially through week one at Oak Ridge, but postseason's probably a little higher priority.
Yeah, we're just we're a new team going forward, so we're just looking to get six wins and make it in the playoffs. Week 10 is our goal right now.
All right, you heard it from Chase Simpson. Chase, thanks for your time. Best of luck this year.
Thank you.
We'll be back after this here on DSC TV.
Family together is like herding cats.
Simplifying things for families is a priority here at Grange Insurance. We offer a variety of policies through Grange Independent Agent.
Your partner in protection.
With four convenient locations, Jack's Corner Store is one-stop shopping at its best. Tools, fresh meats, produce, chips, snacks, and other grocery items, beer, wine, and liquor, even gas and lottery. That's why Jack's is your corner store and so much more.
Whether you're a first-time jewelry browser looking for an extraordinary engagement ring, a couple celebrating your 60th anniversary, or you're just looking to treat yourself or mark an important event, Prothheim & Swanson Gemworks is proud to offer custom-made selections handcrafted in America. Silver, fine-colored gems, diamonds, and gold jewelry, as well as strands of lustrous quality pearls. From ring and watch appraisals to in-house jewelry design and repair, ring sizing, remounting, to a complete rebuilding, you can rely on them to keep your old favorites looking new. K&S Gemworks, Muskegon's community jeweler. Memories made one at a time.
Welcome back to the high school football preview here on DSC TV covering Muskegon Catholic. My name is Matt Chapkus right now, joined with another senior from this Crusaders squad, Nate Jones. And Nate, a little different number this year. After three seasons straight of starting at center, you're moving to an in position. Got to be a little bit excited about the move, aren't you?
I mean, it's a little bit more fun over at end. It's like I compare it to moving down the street a little bit, three houses down. And this house has a pool, which means I get to catch passes. That's about the only thing different. You're still in the same neighborhood, still doing basically the same thing.
All right. Now, when you're looking over to your side and you see those guys, especially the new center on the line, I would assume you're still offering some advice here and there, seeing some things that you can help out with.
I'm always looking to help up the younger guys with what they're doing. I've got a lot of knowledge, and especially at center, I help Bobby a lot. I'd helped him a lot last year. We've kind of got this relationship where if he ever has questions, he comes and asks me, and I help him out.
Okay, now talk about defensively, back at a linebacker position. I would assume this year you're missing some guys around you that you played with last year, but you've also got a lot of guys that got a lot of time in the field because of the games that you were in last year.
Yeah, a lot of the guys got experience last year due to some of the scores that we were putting up. So it's great to have a lot of experience coming back for the guys that don't have as much experience. They have some experience in the games, and they've learned a lot this summer from Coach Rebecca. He's really coaching them up, and I think they're ready to go for week one.
Now, I've heard a lot of guys say that there's been a lot of quality time spent in the weight room, even since last football season got done. Just what impact does that bring when you get out on the field, actually?
Well, it's just the mentality that there's no complacency on this team. Everyone wants to get better. Everyone's trying to improve. So when you approach a football game where each play you're trying to be better than the last play, you have good things that happen.
And you're a senior. You've been starting since your freshman year. Is there ever a moment when you're stepping out there this year where it's a little surreal that you're actually a senior this time around and this is your last go with this Crusader squad?
I mean, it is a little surreal. I don't even feel like I'm a senior yet. It just seems like another season to me, but it'll probably hit me when the season's over and I'll look back and say, wow, I'll never get to ever put on a Crusader football helmet again. But for now, I'm just going to enjoy it while I can and have a fun time with all these guys that I get to play with.
All right, well, we're looking forward to you putting on that helmet starting week one against Oak Ridge. Hey, Jones, thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
We'll take a break and be back after this.
McDonald's Candies, 1064 South Getty Street in Muskegon, features an assortment of chocolate-covered nuts and creams, peanut clusters, fudge, seafoam, turtles, cherry cordials, and regular and holiday novelties. All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building, everybody hands go up. And they stay there, and they say yeah.
Scott behind him, offset to the right, they'll hand it to Tommy, right up the middle he goes, breaks one tackle, he's inside the five, breaks it for the corner, and he will win the race to the end zone, touchdown MCC. Double wings, and they're going to hand it off, that's Johnson coming off the left-hand side, Nate Jones streaks through, and the ball is loose after the play, and the Crusaders recover back at the 27-yard line. With Holt and Jordan in front of Tommy Scott. And a huge hole for Tommy off the right-hand side, and he's in for the touchdown. 20 yards for Tommy Scott, and it's a 13-0 MCC lead. Heavy looking run formation again for the Pirates, and they're going to try going right up the middle, and they're going to go backwards by a yard on second off the first quarter. Holt takes a snap. They'll give it to Helton going right up the middle with it. Watch out. Logan Trees across the 35-40. Gets caught from behind at midfield and taken down at the 47-yard line. Nicholas Holt goes under center. Handoff will be to LaTommy off the right-hand side. Has it inside the 10. Makes a cut back inside, and it's a touchdown, MCC. Here in the first half, standing right at midfield. Hands it off to Tommy Scott. He's right up the middle. He's got a first down and more inside the 30. Turns around one man. He's inside the 20, the 10-5. Touchdown, MCC. Tommy Scott spins Jacob Littwiller right around in the field. Catholic, they'll hand it off. LaTommy Scott off the right-hand side. He's got a big hole, first down and more inside the 40. Taken down out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Now, wing to the left as they hand it off to LaTommy Scott. LaTommy back up the middle, cuts it back to the right side. He's inside the 25, inside the 20, and taken down. That's a penalty for MCC. Littwiller worked from the shotgun. Extreme pass, now huge hit from Lamar Jordan the third on the tight end. We'll check out. And it'll be a handoff to Johnston trying to come off the right-hand side. A great job by Zach Houston to pin him in. Lamar Jordan and company right there. Under center, Helton is the wing on the left side. He'll get it. Going up the middle now, makes a cut back out to the left. He got a nice block, and that'll do it. A touchdown, MCC. Logan Helton goes 15 yards off the left side. Best field position of the game, first and 10 from the 30. Littwiller takes the snap, rolls to his left, trying to pass across the middle, and he is complete. Ball is fumbled into the end zone, and the Crusaders recover in the end zone. It should be a touchback. Crusaders finish with the most points of any team in Division 8 this year. Handoff. It's Woodard up the middle, makes a cut for the end zone, and it's a touchdown, MCC. Dominic Woodard goes 10 yards. How about this, Pat? Coach Steve Zerwan in his career is now 22-2.
It's amazing.
High formation, and it'll hand off to Cook, and he will get stood up at about the 12-yard line out of Harbor Beach. So according to those, we're playing the second-best team. They're going to roll Bengal out to the right, and now he is going to get taken down in the backfield. Michael Collins right there for the Crusaders on the sack. Not in the backfield with him. Holt's going to run this one himself right up the middle. He's got a huge hole. It's at the 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, Nicholas Holt. Touchdown, MCC. Two receivers to either side. Holt from the shotgun. And he's going to keep it himself, going right up the middle. He's inside the 10, inside the 5. Runs the man over into the end zone. Touchdown, MCC. Nicholas Holt, a 20-yard touchdown run with 12.8 seconds to go here in the first quarter. And it runs. Here come the Eagles once again. Bengal under center. Drops back. He is looking to pass, going over top. And that is going to be picked off by Zach Winter at the 47-yard line. He's got behind him. Now Blake Sanford comes in motion, and they're going to hand it to Tommy Scott off the right-hand side. Watch out. He's loose inside the 30, 20. Comes back up the middle inside the 10. A stiff arm, and he's into the end zone. 46 yards. Touchdown, Tommy Scott.
Man, there's Tommy.
Helton and Sanford in the backfield. Nick drops back. He is looking to pass. He's looking for Lamar Jordan over the top. He's got it complete down to the 22-yard line. A gain of 20 yards on the pass and catch. Down in three MCC T formation. Tommy Scott on the right-hand side. He's going to bounce it outside. Race for the corner. He's inside the 5. Dives for the pylon, and it's a touchdown, MCC. Tommy Scott. And that's senior Josh Miller. And they will try and hand it. Watch out. Ball is fumbled, and the Crusaders recover back at the 24-yard line. First down and 10. One receiver wide to either side. Bengal under center. And he is looking for a screen pass to Cook. And Nate Jones cleans it up with your plant of the game. Brought to you by Jinman Tire. Behind Bengal. And he drops back. He is looking to pass. And he gets the pass off, and it's going to be intercepted by Zach Windsor, his second interception of the game. To the left. Now Windsor goes in motion from right to left. And they're going to get a screen pass to Sanford. And he's up across the 30, up across the 40. He's up near midfield. Knocked out of bounds at the...
As long as they can.
Hand off to Latami Scott off the right-hand side. He's got a first down, and Moore makes a cut inside the 5. Touchdown, MCC! Latami Scott goes 15 yards. From a couple different guys, but Coach Perry really working with him now. And they'll hand it off. Blake Sanford off the left-hand side. He's got a first down, and Moore, he's going to race all the way into the end zone, except for a block in the back on next week. Why don't we take a 90-second break? We'll come back with a post-game show brought to you by the Rising of Building Center. The Crusaders advance 42-0 over Fowler here on Country 93.1.
Muskegon's Hackley Public Library is an excellent source for help, information, and great entertainment on virtually any topic. The friendly, knowledgeable staff is always available to help you with finding information on any topic you need. They can help you with using the free public access computers, and they look forward to showing you books, audio CDs, DVDs, and much more. Whether you live in the city or outside, the Hackley Public Library in downtown Muskegon is there to help with everything imaginable.
The Health Hut, located at 3112 Henry Street in Norton Shores, offers a full line of natural and organic groceries, including fresh produce and free-range, hormone-free meats, eggs, cheese, and dairy, provided by local farms. Taking pride in carrying products which contain no preservatives, additives, or unhealthy fats, their wide selection of allergen-free foods can accommodate most specialty diets. From frozen desserts and entrees, to pastas, baking mixes, and cereals, to soups and salad dressings, to chips, candy, and other snacks, the Health Hut. We have your good health in mind.
Benson's Drug Company, the home of Benson's Bottom Paint. Offering an expanded grocery selection, Medicare billing, and diabetes management and education. Benson's now features a Kodak machine, which allows customers to edit, copy, and develop their own photos.
Roll, tumble, jump, and dance with the stars here at Castle Dance and Gymnastics. From 16 months to adults, Castle offers a safe and friendly atmosphere. Located at 1180 Devon Drive, their number is 231-798-8418. Or find them at castlegymdance.com.
City Glass and Mirror features glass for every purpose, servicing both residential and commercial. Their full-service showroom displays every aspect of what City Glass has to offer: handrails, closet systems, replacement windows, bath hardware, shower doors, and custom mirrors. They even offer auto glass and storefronts to see all they have to offer. City Glass and Mirror, located at 100 West 7th Street in Grand Haven and 631 Commerce Court, Suite 10 in Holland.
Clever's got nowhere to go. The Crusaders stuff him on third down. And the Hornets will have to be back to Tommy Scott, Logan Helton, and Blake Stanford. Tommy Scott gets it off the right-hand side. A big hole up the middle. He's inside the 40. He's loose inside the 25, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, MCC on the first play from scrimmage. Tommy Scott goes 47 yards.
And Mark is going to keep himself in.
Up again and just gets crushed in the backfield. Jacob Holt slowed him down, and Jaden McPherson took him down for another 2 yards.
In motion, takes the handoff to Tommy Scott. Nicholas keeps it himself.
He's got a hole up the middle. First down and more. He breaks loose at midfield. 40, 30, the flag down on the play as he goes 20, 10, 5, 82-yard touchdown. But will it stand for MC?
Takes the handoff, puts himself, runs through a tackle. He's across the 40.
He's across midfield, taken down at the 43-yard line of Mendon.
Takes the handoff, and he is rolling back. He's looking fast. He's got nowhere to go.
And Kimbrough intercepts it at the 47-yard line of MCC. Jake Kimbrough reaches up high with two hands and pulls it in. It's first and 10 Crusaders. He's got a big hole and he's loose. 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown MCC. Blake Stanford goes 50 yards and the Crusaders.
First down and more, breaks it off the left hand side inside the 35, down to the 30 and knocked out of bounds.
Off to Tommy, and he's got some space inside the 20, 10, 5, touchdown MCC. Tommy Scott off the option, goes 22 yards, and that touchdown.
He's out in the field right now, and now the Hornets going to go to the shot clock. Takes the handoff, Cook is buried, and Scott with the fourth on the center. From the left back, Tommy Scott off the right hand side.
Watch out, Tommy's loose. Inside the 30, breaks the tackle inside the 20, 10, 5, touchdown, Tommy Scott, 47 yards again, and it's a 26-0, Muskegon Catholic lead.
Went off to the left, Cook goes under center for the Hornets, and he is looking to pass again. Drops back, looks underneath, it's picked up by Kimbrough again!
Jake Kimbrough's second interception of the game, returns it inside the 35, down
in. Holt takes the handoff, keeps it to himself off the right-hand side. He's got one man to beat. Goes inside the 10, 5, touchdown MCC!
Nicholas Holt, 31 yards, and the Crusaders are cruising it 33-7.
Two to the left, two to the right of Cook. In the backfield, and he's going to hand it off, and Pump's going to get dropped in the backfield.
Jake Kimbrough with your plan to the game.
Cook's going to keep it this time, and he meets Jaden McPherson and Jacob Holt. It's a key formation now. Nicholas Holt under center. Off the right hand side, and watch out, he's got a big hole. Makes a man miss. He's across the 40. Nicholas Holt
Holt goes under center for the Crusaders. Handoff is Logan Helton right up the middle. Watch out, he's across midfield, and he is loose to the 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown, MCC. Logan Helton goes 63 yards for the score on the first play of the second half. Just gets lit up by Lamar Jordan the third. Back at the 26-yard line, a loss of four on the play. First quarter. Formation again. Nicholas Holt under center. Thomas got to get off the right-hand side. He's inside the 15, inside the 10, inside the 5. Keeps his feet, and it's a touchdown, MCC. Tommy. Right up the middle, he's got a big first down and more. Logan Helton free again, inside the 30, 20, 10, 5. Touchdown,
you're looking for that exclusive, hot, Logan fresh out the booth music with your favorite artists, the latest, most buzzing, crazy entertainment news that keeps your face glued to the screen, and the sexiest, exotic women that you'll find all on one site, and visit hiphopfarmbeat.com. The Day of the Born website is over.
The post-game show brought to you by the Rising and Building Center. The Crusaders survive in advance.
Brenda Sprader. Facing serious legal problems alone can be disappointing and stressful. When your freedom, your loved ones, or your finances are at stake, it is important to seek legal representation. I'm an experienced trial attorney and will work hard to protect what is important to you. I strive for equitable resolution and provide confidential guidance. I cannot promise specific results, but I do promise to be committed to zealously fighting to ensure that your rights are protected and that justice is served. If you would like to meet with me to discuss your legal issues, please call the number on your screen for a free consultation.
Since 1980, Winston Speedway has been bringing the best of West Michigan dirt track racing to the Lakeshore. Late models, UMP modifieds, Michigan dirt modifieds, street stocks, bombers, warriors, and young guns, featuring 11 to 16-year-old drivers. Between races, you can visit Winston Speedway's Candy Shack, where you'll find your favorite t-shirts, racing memorabilia, and pick from an assortment of candy. Or you can stop by the concession stand for pulled pork sandwiches, burgers, cheeseburgers, Polish dogs, hot dogs, french fries, as well as hot and cold beverages. Winston Speedway every Friday night. Pits open at 5, grandstand at 6, hot laps at 6:30, and racing begins at 7:30. For more information, you can call 231-737-9223 to reach the office or 231-893-3023 on race day.
All right, and we are ready to get things underway here from Alma College. Division 8 semifinals. Let's look at the starting lineup. Now Shelke from the shotgun sends a man in motion, fakes the pitch, rolls to his left, looking for an opening, doesn't have one, throws a dangerous pass, it's picked off by MCC inside the 10-yard line. Nate Jones comes away with it for the Crusaders.
Oh, that's a nice pick. That's a big play.
Scott right behind Christian. No hand it off. Tommy going up the middle with it. Watch out, he breaks loose. He's across the 25, 30, 35, 40. Nobody's going to catch him. Tommy Scott is loose. 20, 10, touchdown MCC. Tommy Scott, 89 yards, and the Crusaders are on top with 3:35 to go in the first quarter of play. Lansky from the shotgun, two to the right, one to the left, and he's going to keep this one himself, and he gets stacked up right at the line of scrimmage. From the shotgun, one back there with him, two stacked to either side. He's going to keep it himself, and he is going to get stood up and dropped for a loss. Great job by the Crusader defense.
Shelke staying on his own 39 from the shotgun, takes the snap, and he is looking to throw. Doesn't have anywhere. Watch out, he lost the ball. The ball taken away by Muskegon Catholic. It's Crusader ball. And Blake Sanford, Christian Martinez under center. Martinez keeps it himself, goes right up the middle, and he's in. Touchdown, FCC! Christian Martinez on the keeper, and it's 13-0 Crusaders. Christian under center. It'll be Blake Sanford off the left-hand side. He's inside the five, squirts through, he's inside, and it's a touchdown, FCC! Blake Sanford goes 8 yards for the score with 2:28 to go here in the first half. Spread look two to either side, Shelkey. Hands it off to Lemanski this time, and he got nowhere, and Jaden McPherson drops him. No gain, might have even lost half a yard either side from the right hash. Shelkey takes a snap, drops back. He's looking to pass and gets a screen pass, and it's going to get dropped for a loss as Lemanski took it, but the Crusader defensive line ate him up. Is Martinez goes under center. Goes Sanford off the left-hand side. Sanford cuts his way in, and he's in. Touchdown, FCC. Blake Sanford on the three-yard run. Two backs, one to either side, two to the left, one to the right. And he's going to run the option, and that's not going to go anywhere. Lemanski's going to get dropped right at the line. No gain. We'll call second and 10. Now they'll give it to Tommy Scott out of the T formation. Off the right-hand side. Watch out. He's loose. Inside the 40, 30. Oh, and he slipped at the 29. The backfield as well. Tommy Scott off the left-hand side. Cuts it back inside. He's inside the 15. Spins through a man, and he's in. Touchdown, FCC. Tommy Scott, 21 yards. T formation again. Tommy Scott off the right-hand side. Bounces it outside inside the 10-yard line. Carrying a runner down inside the 5 to the 4. First down and goal, Muskegon Catholic. Sanford and Latami Scott, they'll pitch it to Latami. Tries to use his speed, keeps his feet, is inside the five, fights for the end zone, and it's a touchdown, MCC. Latami Scott with the touchdown run, 5 yards, and it's 41-6. Crusaders with nine. Operates from the shotgun, two to the right to the short side of the field, one to the left, and they will run it out there. And Nate Jones is going to hold him up and stop him at the 43, and that's over. Muskegon Catholic Central is on to the state championship game for the second straight year, 42-6. Here's your final score. We'll take a two-minute break, and we'll come back and talk a little bit about Ford Field coming up next week. The Crusaders.
Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost.
chance to travel the world, but I don't have any plans. Wish that I could stay forever this young, not afraid to close my eyes. Life's a game made for everyone, and love is the prize. So wake me up when it's all over, when I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself, and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up.
In the 150 years we've been in business, many things have changed. Our greatest achievements are rooted in the things that haven't. Years ago, the person you called banker was also the person you called friend. When it came to service, there were fewer layers and friendlier smiles. And banks earned the trust of their customers and community while working tirelessly not to lose it. At Independent Bank, all this remains true today. Sure, we've made advances that help customers bank more conveniently and more comfortably. But at the end of the day, we know that people really need a trustworthy partner committed to their financial goals, dreams, and aspirations. And we've been happy to be that partner since 1864.
Established in 1973 by Paul M. Lattice, Lattice and Hoops Law Offices has been a multi-service law firm specializing in accident cases, personal injury, wrongful death, Social Security disability, divorce, probate and wills, and real estate. When it comes to choosing the right attorney for your legal needs, don't choose out of town, choose local legal counsel. It really pays. It's experience when it counts. It's Lattice and Hoops Law Offices.
We're here on the streets of Nashville, introducing people to Culver's fresh frozen custard. How about some custard?
This is amazing.
How are you guys liking the frozen custard?
It's so good.
One word to describe it.
Better.
Better than?
Better than ice cream.
Craveable.
Very smooth.
Perfect. Yes, she's a keeper. You're gonna need to marry her now.
Creamy and cool, that's nice.
So it's got rich, fresh dairy, and that's what gives it that really creamy texture. So you'd like to try some frozen custard.
Be a custard hero. Introduce somebody to Culver's fresh frozen custard.
It almost tastes like it's homemade.
I think somebody loves it.
It's good.
It's so creamy. It's not what I expected at all.
Culver's is the best custard. They know just how to make it good.
One, two, three, Culver's!
Welcome to Delicious.